Now, let me take the opportunity to introduce our first speaker of the day, Mr. Milind D. Rane, Senior Manager HR, Windworld India Limited. Sir, may I have your permission to begin, please? Thank you, sir. Sir is a dynamic professional with 22 years of rich experience in devising HR policies, system, and programs. Sir has completed his PG diploma in training and development from Indian Society of Training and Development, New Delhi, and Bachelor's of General Law from Jitendra Chauhan College of Law, Mumbai. Sir has also completed his personal management from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Management Studies and Research from University of Mumbai. Sir is expertise in manpower, planning, and integrated talent management, and also efficient in handling the development and administration of performance management program in the organization. With this, I request sir to kindly address the batch.
So good afternoon, everyone. I do not like to hide behind the dais, okay? So I'll be more interacting with you people. And it's really a pleasure for me to be in Pune, right? Punekers, what is the first thing comes up in mind? Very loving? Just raise your hand and tell, how are they? Enthusiastic. Good, the Punekers are listening, okay? They're enthusiastic. Fine, but you have been in Pune a couple of months now? Okay, good. So I'll be interacting one-to-one, be more with you people, right? It's a great pleasure with 22 years of experience to be here with you. I'm a marathoner, okay? Guess my age, what my age will be? 45. Who said 45? Wow, well done. Let's clap for them, well done. So I'll stop counting after 25, okay? I'm just your age, 4-5 years elder than you. That keeps me fit because of marathon. As corporate honchos, or as you get into a corporate world, your fitness is going to be very important. And I want to talk today about goal setting. I want someone to define what is a goal. What is a goal? Football ka goal nahi, yeah? Goal post. Someone, come on, I want answers, right? Like, I want you to really be on your toes. You have to be a sponge today, okay? Sponge means, you understand? Mumukshu. Mumukshu means, it's a Sanskrit word which says absorb. You have to absorb, pull the session towards you. We are trained landmark leaders. If you have anyone heard about the Landmark Forum, a 3 days transformational program, it's an international program. No one heard about the Landmark Forum? Oh, surprising. At least once in your life, do this 3 days transformational program. Heard about Tony Robbins? Yes, good. What do you know about Tony Robbins? Someone? Come on, huh? Wonderful. He's the top three in the world. Can you imagine? Well, let's clap for him. Always acknowledge people. Start acknowledging people, and let's do it's really in a very innovative way. Let's do in an innovative way. How we'll do it? We'll do one finger clapping three times. Come on, take this hand like this. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay? So even when you're clapping, you have to be consciously clapping. Not because the post-lunch session is the most difficult session. For US participants and for us as a trainer or a faculty, always get that. Because a lot of energy goes into digestion, yes. And less goes into absorbing in the gray matter of your mind, like the left brain and the right brain. But girls are better, okay? They use both the brains very well. They are like my son. Okay, I'm married, I have a son, 13 years old. He always says, no, we are smarter. But get it now, the Me Too movement is making them more smarter, okay? So you better respect them, have empathy with them. Don't give any taunts, because that is also going to a Me Too movement, you don't know. The guys, are you listening? Okay? My voice is audible?
Yeah.
Clear. So coming back to Tony Robbins, Tony Robbins had just $26 with him. He was broke. He went to a hotel, ate his lunch, about $8. How much remains after $8? $18. He gave a tip, about $1 or $2. So $2 le lo. Kitna ro gaya? $16. And he sees a young teenager coming with his mother or whoever, lady in the hotel. And from the face, he sees that young person may not be having money. So he thinks for himself. If he's bringing his mother or the older lady, maybe a grandmother, to the hotel, it's a big thing. Let me put this in his pocket. And he's going to be totally broke after giving that left money. He has no money to have his next dinner also, or next tea also, or coffee. Imagine, Tony Robbins, one of the biggest motivation speaker during those time also, is about to be broke. And he gives that money, keeps into his pocket of that young guy, teenager. No money in pocket. Imagine how you will feel. But when he comes back, he opens his door and sees an envelope, and in an envelope a $1,200 check written by his friend who had taken his money long time ago. Are you getting that point? So when he gave everything to this teenager, he got a $1,200 check. So the bottom line, Tony Robbins says that I got the gift of giving. So I am here to give you my 22 years of knowledge of HR. It's up to you how you pull that knowledge towards you. Right? On goal setting. So bottom line of Tony Robbins' story, give. And start giving unconditional love. Now is the festival of Navratri, of all Durgas. Right? The power, the energy. And you all traveling from different locations, so many kilometers, you have to learn the best of education that you are getting in this IEBM school. It's you are the few chosen lucky ones to be here to get this knowledge, international knowledge, from me to other faculties who are there with you. We are trained. We have to do a mirror exercise 3 hours to 8 hours when I lead in Landmark Forum. Introduction to Landmark Forum. So that's the power each one of you have to create that future for you through this session of goal setting. Right? So everyone got the story of Tony Robbins? So what was the message? The art of giving. The art of sharing. Even whatever you have, give that back to the society. It can be knowledge, it need not be money. It can be knowledge or service. I was with Mayank. Mayank is here, Indore. Indore is one of the best Swachh Bharat cities. Right? Indore, Bhopal. How it is? Because they are really putting their life to keep their city clean. To keep it speak and span. It's like if you have worked with Japanese, everything that they keep also as a place, they call it 5S. Have you heard about 5S? Seri, Seito, Saiso, Saiketsu and Shitsuke. Shitsuke is the self-standardization. Everything speak and span. If we reach Shitsuke na, we'll be the developed country in the world. We are still, as what I observe, we are at 2S here in this organization also. This bags also not properly kept. It has to be proper place. It's now it is properly kept. You could see how it was first, like this. Means it was little curved. When he kept it properly, leaning to the wall, that's a proper first S, Seri. There is a proper place to everything. So coming back to Indians, we Indians are nothing less, okay? Than Japanese or Germans or Americans also. It's only the mindset that has to be transformed. That chalta hai attitude. Chalta hai. Thuk diya, fake diya.